name is Bridget. Welcome to my channel. For today's video, we're going to be talking about some tips that I have on herp keeping. Now, I'm sure you all know what a herp is, but just in case you've never heard of it, it is basically a reptile or an amphibian. And these are animals that are frequently kept in captivity, just as I do. And so they're often referred to as herps instead of just saying reptiles or amphibians. So today I'm going to be talking about tips that I have for herp keeping. Now, I have not been keeping my herps for as long as other people have. I've been keeping for almost 4 years now. So it's not a super long time, but I feel like it's long enough that I can give you some tips that I've learned along the way just to kind of make things a little smoother for myself. Now, when keeping reptiles and amphibians, because they are very exotic pets that need very specific care, it's important to kind of be on your game with this. This is definitely not your everyday neighborhood type of pet keeping. It takes a lot of knowledge, it takes a lot of responsibility, a lot of money, and a lot of work, but it's a lot of fun. So even though herp keeping is definitely not a walk in the park, these tips that I have to share with you will definitely make that walk a little bit easier. Tip number one, educate yourself. Do your research. Make sure you know exactly what you're keeping and what that animal needs. You're never gonna have success keeping a reptile or an amphibian if you don't know what the animal is specifically and how to take care of it. So definitely do as much research as humanly possible. And I also recommend never stop researching. Science is changing all the time and new things are discovered all the time. So even if you've had an animal for 10 years, definitely continue to do research on them to make sure that nothing is changing so that you can make sure to give them a long and happy life and give them all the care that they need. Tip number two, keep records of your animals, and I also recommend keeping care guides for them. So in keeping records of them, you want to keep track of past vet visits, any changes that they've made, any improvements that have come about, any kind of health issues or concerns that you may have had. And when it comes to the care guides, I just recommend keeping a basic type of care guide written down just to have something to refer to if you need a quick reminder. Tip number three, be aware of your animal's current status. What I mean by that is their food digestion, their current bowels, how well they're eating, their activity level, their shedding cycle, any behavioral or hormonal changes. Just make sure you know exactly what your animal is up to and how they're feeling at the time so you can gauge if anything's going on and if they need any special treatment or changes or anything else. You cannot ask these animals how they're feeling or how they're doing, so it's up to you to make sure that you are watching them on a daily basis and seeing if there's anything going on with them that needs to be changed. Tip number four, find an exotics vet. There are so many people who keep these types of animals that don't have an exotics vet, and that's fine. You do things the way that you feel you need to, but I don't think that you should have an animal if you don't also have a vet that could take care of them. I know exotics vets are not all over the place. They're not as readily available as your standard everyday veterinarian. So sometimes they're out of town, sometimes they're a 2-hour drive, sometimes they're even further than that. And in those types of instances, if you don't have that access or you don't have the ability or the will to make those kinds of drives, then I definitely don't recommend getting that animal, because let's face it, things are gonna happen, illnesses are gonna happen, injuries are gonna happen, and so who else is gonna take care of that animal besides some professional who knows what they're doing? I am fortunate to have an exotics vet for all of my babies, but not everyone is, so I recommend either finding one as close to you as possible or potentially rethinking keeping that animal. Now, there are so many at-home treatments that are safe and reliable, but I still think it's best to make sure that you're checking all of those boxes and be sure to have a professional opinion to make sure that there is an appropriate and safe treatment plan in place. Tip number five, keep a calendar and know important dates. Now, you should be keeping a calendar for your own benefit anyways, but it's also pretty useful to have one for your animals as well. If there's any kind of upcoming checkup for them, because I do recommend taking them in every now and then just to make sure that they have a general health check going on. If you have any medications that you need to give, little reminders on feeding schedule. You know, if you have a snake that's eating every week or maybe one that's eating every 10 days, write it on the calendar so you can remember to not forget that feeding day. I also like to mark the birthdays of my animals so that I don't forget. But it's up to you what you want to put on the calendar. I just recommend that you get one. Tip number six, have a daily schedule. Now, daily routines are gonna change depending on the animal, so it's really good to have a daily schedule in place that you can refer to, because each day is gonna be different. Whether it be some kind of notebook that you keep track of it, or maybe a calendar, maybe a dry erase board, it's just really good to have that specific day's tasks written down so that you don't miss anything. Tip number 7, have a cleaning schedule. Now, each enclosure should be spot cleaned as often as possible, but it's really important that you do a complete tear down of the enclosure and clean it all out once a month. So I think it's really helpful to have a schedule that tells you what enclosures actually do. Now, there are some people who choose to do all of their enclosures on the exact same day, so they have one day where they do all the clean outs. I am not about that life. So I personally keep a schedule for myself where there are specific days within the month that I clean a specific species enclosure. So for example, the first Tuesday of every month, I clean out my two large lizards enclosures, my bearded dragon and my uromastix. The following Tuesday, I'll do my two leopard gecko enclosures, and it just goes on like that. So I basically do my cleaning in twos, where I do two enclosures on a specific day. And every Tuesday and almost every Wednesday, I'm doing some sort of enclosure. Tip number 8, have really good storage and organization. I recommend keeping all of your same items together, like keep your food items together, all of your supplements together, all of your cleaning products together, all of your feeder insects together. You get the idea. It's really, really helpful when you have everything in the same place and nothing's just scattered around the room. So in my animal room here, I have several different storage areas and everything has its place. I like to live my life that way anyways, where everything has its place, but especially with keeping these reptiles and my amphibian, it just makes life a little bit easier when I have a place for something and I know that it's gonna be there when I go after it. Tip number 9, check on them at least twice a day, but preferably more. You never want your animals to be in a situation where they have to fend for themselves because you aren't there for them. So it's wonderful and acceptable, of course, to check on them once every morning and once every evening. A lot of people have full-time jobs they have to go to every day. That's fine. But I do recommend with these types of animals to check on them at least one other time throughout the day, if not more. I probably come in this room 10 to 15 times a day because I'm here every day, I'm with them, and I just don't like the idea of not knowing what they're doing, what they're up to, what their temperatures are, all that kind of stuff. I am very overbearing. I'm a hovering mother, and I don't think there's anything wrong with that. If you have the time and you're able to check on your animals, check on them several times a day. If you can only do it a couple times a day, that's fine too. Just do thorough checks. You need to be able to see everything that's going on in order to prevent any kind of injury or illness, tragedies, any abnormal amounts of poo that is spread everywhere. You just never know. These animals like to keep you on your toes, so it is really important to make sure that you're looking at them and their enclosures to see what's going on. And when going on vacation, I recommend having someone that can stay with your animals in the same house that they're in. But if you don't have someone that can do that, then definitely have someone that can at least come to your house and check on the animals twice per day. But one thing that I do for my bird when I'm gone from the house is I actually have a camera for her. There's several cameras that you can buy on the internet. I'll link the one that I have down below. Got it from Amazon. You just set it up, you use an app on your phone, and you can watch your animals while you aren't there. I don't have one yet in the animal room, but I am getting one within the next couple of weeks, I think, so that I can also check on them when I'm not here. It's not often that I'm not here, honestly, I have no life, but when I'm not here, it'd be nice to look at my bird as well as my animal room. Tip number 10, wash your hands or use hand sanitizer before and after handling your animals. You never know what's on your hands that could be transferred to your animal, and you never know what's on your animal that could be transferred to you. Though it's very unlikely that you would catch something from your animal, and I would think that if there's something you could catch from the animal, that you've already taken steps to treat that, but you just never know. It's better to be safe than sorry. And there are several things on your hands that you could transfer to your animal. So that is definitely not something you want to risk. So we use our hand sanitizer before and after handling each of our animals as well. Even if we're going to handle several of them in the same day, just to make sure that none of them can transfer anything to each other. I have personally made the decision to not have any of my animals come in contact with one another. They may live in an enclosure that's right next door, but I don't ever have two of them out at the same time. I don't ever handle them back to back without cleaning my hands off first. You get the idea. You don't have to do it that way. I'm just very particular, so that's the way that I do it. But my point is, you need to make sure your hands are clean before you handle an animal, and just make sure your hands are clean after, just to make sure that you also stay clean after handling your animal, because they may have feces on them. You just never know. Just clean your hands. And tip number 11, my final tip, enjoy it and embrace it. It is an amazing, life-changing experience to have a little piece of nature living within your home with you and living within your care. It is honestly so much fun. I definitely think that you should not acquire any animals other than the sole purpose of loving them and having that big desire in your heart to have them. I think that if you don't enjoy the animal, you should not have it. And I think that numbers mean absolutely nothing. If you get animals just to say, I have so many pets, you're doing it wrong. You should embrace your sweet babies whether you have one or whether you have 40. Heart keeping is just incredible. So do your best, love them with your whole heart, and just be grateful that you get to have this unique opportunity. So that's all I have for you today, guys. Just giving you some tips that I have come up with along the way on heart keeping and making life a little bit easier. While it's already wonderful to keep them, it can be crazy. So I hope that they help you guys. If you have any other tips that I may have missed or things that you think could help me out, definitely leave them in the comment section down below. If you enjoyed today's video, please give us a big thumbs up and hit that subscribe button on your way out. I really appreciate it. Also hit that notification bell so you can know when I upload next, and I will see you in my next video. Bye!